Hey guys, so today we have a very special guest here on my channel. This guest is Cristhian from Honduras, and I'm very honored of having him here with me because he's a polyglot, he likes learning languages, and today he's here to talk a little bit about his experience. As we have a lot of languages in common, we're going to talk together in different languages like Spanish, English, German, French, and so on. All right, Chris, so thank you for being here. And would you like to introduce yourself briefly and tell me, for example, which languages you speak and what do you do for a living and so on?
Okay, well, first of all, thank you so much for having me in your channel, Andrea. It is an honor. I have to tell you that when I started having ideas for making my polyglot video, as you know, we all have these polyglots. We all have like our videos to show to the world the languages we speak. And I remember you watching you first and getting ideas from your polyglot video. I remember that you and Patrick Curry were the ones that I used to watch. So I said, I'm going to watch these guys. And I remember you watching your channel, and now I am in your channel. So that's kind of crazy. So it is an honor. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. So I'm going to start with my introduction. My name is Cristhian. I'm from Honduras, a very small country from Latin America, in the center of the whole American continent. The languages I speak is Spanish, my mother tongue, Spanish, English, French, German, Italian, Chinese. And I have studied also Greek, Finnish, and Russian.
Oh, that's impressive, actually. Yeah. Congratulations. And believe me, it's really a pleasure to have you here. Right. So maybe we can start to ask you something in your native language. So in Espanol, ¿vale? Bueno, me has dicho que eres de Honduras. Y yo me estaba preguntando si el español hondureño es un español con sus particularidades. ¿Es más cercano al español de México o al español de Sudamérica? ¿Qué me puedes decir?
Bueno, pienso que de una u otra manera hay un español neutro, por así decirlo. Bien sabemos que el español de España es bien característico. Pero también en Latinoamérica siempre hay como que un acento o algo que identifica el español de cada país. Pienso que el español de los países cercanos a Honduras, por ejemplo, Salvador, Nicaragua, Guatemala, son los más parecidos con el de Costa Rica también. Ahora, ya el acento, por ejemplo, mexicano o argentino o colombiano, ya es como que un poco más más diferente, ya se siente un poco más, pero obviamente se entiende, pues, o sea, yo voy a México y no tengo problemas, no tengo ningún problema. Pienso que el acento centroamericano o hondureño, puedo decir, es como una combinación entre el de México con el del sur, pienso. Eso es lo que podría considerar, aunque cada país sí tiene como que su acento característico. Obviamente no digamos palabras, ¿no? Palabras. Hay palabras que dicen en Colombia que uno no entiende. Por ejemplo, arrecho, por ejemplo, es como estar enojado, ¿no? Nosotros en Honduras decimos, ay, es que estás arrecho, estás enojado. Pero en Perú creo que es arrecho es otra cosa, es como estar como excitado, pero de forma sexual. Entonces, sí, cambia el significado. Entonces, sí hay palabras que cambian, pero el acento creo que considero que un poco más distintivo como en el sur, en Chile, en Argentina. Pero es un español que se entiende en toda América Latina.
Vale, muy interesante. Eso es lo que me gusta más del idioma español, que cada país tiene su acento, tiene sus palabras que los otros no pueden comprender. Y es muy divertido, la verdad. Y me gustaría sí. conocer todas las palabras, pero es imposible porque de verdad hay muchísimas.
Es totalmente imposible. Inclusive, por ejemplo, creo que es en Nicaragua, de que nosotros en Honduras, al niño, por ejemplo, cuando miramos a un niño, le decimos bicho, uh-huh. cipote o bicho. Pero en Nicaragua, creo que es en Nicaragua, bicho, se le dice a la parte íntima de la mujer. Entonces, ahí como que puede haber un malentendido, pero ellos mismos entienden. Uh-huh. Ellos mismos entienden que si utilizan tal vez esa palabra, pues no es de ahí, ¿no? Creo que es en Nicaragua, no sé si me estoy equivocando, pero creo que es. Sí.
Vale. Sí. Y bueno, oltre allo spagnolo parli anche l'italiano, che è la mia lingua madre invece. E ecco, volevo chiederti come mai, perché hai deciso di imparare l'italiano?
Va bene, ho deciso di imparare l'italiano perché è una lingua che mi piace molto, una lingua molto simile alla mia lingua madre. Mi piaceva totalmente parlare questa lingua, imparare questa lingua. Uh-huh. È per questo che ho deciso di impararla, perché è una lingua molto bella, simile al spagnolo, alla mia lingua madre. Sì, esa è la ragione. Credo che tutti i poliglotti vogliono imparare questa lingua.
Sei mai stato in Italia?
Non sono mai stato in Italia. Credo che è un sogno per molte persone di andare in Italia, perché è un paese molto bello. Sicuramente che tutti vogliono andare in Italia. Sì, credo che è un paese che ha influenzato molto con la sua cultura e mm-hmm. molti paesi nel mondo, credo.
Certo, sì, è vero. Hai una città che ti piacerebbe visitare?
Non lo so, magari Sud Italia o magari Roma. Non lo so, credo che Toscana, la Toscana, ho ascoltato mm-hmm. molto Toscana, è molto, molto bello. Anche credo che tutto il paese è bello, la verità, certo. Bello, la gente, la cultura, sì, totalmente.
No, grazie. Und du sprichst auch Deutsch, oder?
Ja, ich spreche auch Deutsch, nicht perfekt, aber ich spreche auch Deutsch.
Super, also wie lernst du Deutsch?
Naja, ich habe Deutsch gelernt. Ich habe angefangen in 2013, glaube ich. Und für mich, ich war ein bisschen schwer, weil ich habe noch nie in der Schule gewesen, für Deutsch zu lernen. Mhm. Und ich wollte einfach germanische Sprache lernen und ich habe angefangen. Und nach habe ich angelernt. Habe ich Deutsch gelernt.
Ah, toll, super. Und ich wollte auch fragen, hast du viele Länder besucht in der Welt?
Nein. Ich habe noch nicht in sehr viele Länder gewesen. Ich habe nur in Ländern in der Nähe gewesen. Mhm. Aber Natürlich, die Pandemie hat mich davon abgehalten, weil, aber das wird sich verändern. Das wird sich ändern, vielleicht nächste Jahre. Hoffe ich, ein bisschen mehr zu reisen. Mhm. Ja, ich hatte die Idee, die letzten Jahre nach Europa zu fahren, aber aufgrund der Pandemie sehr schwer.
Ja, leider. hoffentlich wird es alles
Ja,
besser.
vielleicht nächste
Ja.
Jahre. Vielleicht nächste Jahre.
Ja, sicherlich. Ok,
Oui.
maintenant nous parlons un petit peu en français. Tu parles aussi le français. Et je voudrais demander qu'est-ce que tu penses? Quelle langue latine est la plus facile pour les Espagnols à apprendre?
Bon, je pense que pour les gens qui parlent l'espagnol comme langue maternelle, je pense que le portugais et l'italien sont les langues les plus faciles à apprendre. Oui, je pense que c'est ça. Et préparation pour le catalan, le portugais sont les langues les plus faciles. Et il y a beaucoup de similarités. Et la prononciation, c'est pas difficile, et oui.
Oui, je suis d'accord. Par exemple, pour moi, le français n'est pas très facile parce que je trouve difficile l'écriture, par exemple, l'orthographe, la phonétique aussi. Et, je crois qu'il y a des langues qui sont plus faciles. Oui.
Exactement, la langue plus facile totalement sont l'italien, le portugais et le français. Et le français, c'est très difficile pour les gens normalement, et pour la prononciation, je pense. C'est un peu très difficile et aussi pour l'écriture, parce que quelquefois, l'écriture et la prononciation, on peut dire que ce n'est pas la même chose parce qu'on voit beaucoup de lettres dans le papier, mais quand on va le prononcer, on ne prononce pas beaucoup de mots qui sont écrits. C'est très difficile, c'est un peu difficile à comprendre au début, mais avec le temps, évidemment, ça va.
Je crois que c'est la même situation de la langue polonaise. On écrit beaucoup de lettres, mais on prononce seulement petites lettres en polonais.
Tu parles polonais?
Non, mais je connais quelques personnes qui parlent polonais et on m'a dit ça. Oui.
Je tiens de dire que le polonais, c'est très difficile.
Oui. Plus difficile que les Russes, je pense.
Parce que je comprends russe. Je ne parlais pas les russes, évidemment. Parfaitement, mais je te dis un peu, mais les polonais, je te dis que c'est très difficile.
Хорошо, ты немного говоришь по-русски.
Я не говорю по-русски хорошо, но чуть-чуть, я думаю.
Чуть-чуть. Ну, хорошо.
я думаю.
Oh, yeah, there's another question I wanted to ask you, and it's about Kipia. Actually, I know that you are a member of this very important association of hyperpolyglots. So I wanted to ask what does it mean to you to be a part of this association?
Well, for me, it is an honor. It is a pleasure. First of all, to be the first, I can say, in my country to be in this group. And it means a lot. It means a lot because I can share with a lot of people from all over the world things. I can share things. I have met a very amazing people there. So it's truly a pleasure. And I think that there is, I can say this, that there is a before and after before I entered Hypia, because at the same time I started my YouTube channel. And knowing Polyglot people has helped me a lot. First of all, because I feel like in a family, because in my country, learning languages is not that popular. You know, so I
Yeah.
felt like some kind of way alone, you know, like I'm the only one. But then through internet, obviously you meet a lot of people, and yeah. And second of all, because in Hypia, there's a lot of Polyglots, so I can have material to record for my YouTube channel. So I can meet a lot of people. I can invite people to my channel to do videos. So that has helped me a lot, because I have like a bag full of interesting people, smart people, and I can pick up a country like, okay, today I'm going to do an interview with someone from Finland, the another day from Italian, the day from Italy, the another day from Russia. So it's amazing. It's totally amazing.
Yeah, I agree with you. Actually, being a member of this association opens up a lot of new possibilities, and it's very cool, actually.
Yeah, for example, it's like YouTube has, for example, okay, I have an interview with someone from Spain. Okay, now I'm going to pick up someone from France. Let's do it. So, you know.
Yeah, yeah, that's great. All right, Cristhian. And are there any other languages that you would like to learn in the future? What are your plans?
Well, my plan is to master the languages that are on my list. Like, for example, the languages that are on my list right now, Greek, Finnish, Russian, I think, to master Chinese, that I've been studying it for almost a year. And maybe to add Turkish. I like Turkish, Japanese, Hebrew. I like Hebrew. Yeah, I think that those are the languages. I would like more, like, for example, Swedish, you know.
Yeah.
I like Swedish. The first step right now is to master the languages that they're on my list right now, languages to master, and then let's see what happens. Yeah.
Yeah. Have you ever thought of learning a local American language? I don't know, like Quechua or something like this.
Sorry, like Native American?
Yeah, exactly.
Native American? No. No, I haven't really, like, checked
thought about
that.
It. Mm-hmm.
Have you?
Well, actually, I wanted to learn Quechua when I was younger.
Ah, Quechua. Uh-huh.
Yeah, but I mean, there's not a lot of material available, especially here in Italy, and so I gave it up. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That's kind of. Why do you want to learn that?
I don't know. It just sounds cool. I mean, nobody speaks it in Europe, so.
Yeah, no, sometimes you feel attracted to something that is not common, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Just for the pleasure of it.
Yeah, the pleasure to speak that. Yeah, I know.
Good. E al principio del video me dijiste que hablas también chino. Entonces, ¿quieres concluir esta entrevista diciendo algo en este idioma?
Of course.
Wow. no he entendido nada.
It was very simple. I mean, it's hard. I'm going to tell you something is hard, but it's not impossible. Like, for example, polyglots like you that live in Europe, I think that can learn it fast. For me, it has been very hard, but it's not impossible. It's just dedication. So I said that it was very simple. I said that show to the world what you can do.
Mm-hmm.
And follow what you believe you are good at, and to show to the world you can do whatever you want.
Oh, wow. That's a very good message.
Yeah, because normally sometimes you don't trust yourself. That's what happened to me when I was a teen. I didn't have any confidence. I wanted to do things, but sometimes I was afraid to people's opinion. Mm-hmm. And then I said, once you realize what you can do, you just do whatever you want.
Well, yeah, that is true. I totally can relate to your words. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. So thank you, Cristhian, for being here and answering to my questions. It was really a pleasure to talk to you. And
the pleasure was for me, Andrea.
Oh, thank you. And so, guys, remember to subscribe to Cristhian's channel. Maybe you can tell us the name of it.
Yeah, Chris 16. I think that Chris 16 channel. Yeah.
All right. And then
it's going to appear somewhere.
Exactly. Or also below in the video description. Yeah. Good. So I hope you guys enjoyed our interview together. And if you have any questions, you can leave a comment. Cristhian and I are going to answer. And that's all for today. So thank you and goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.